Classified. We were just talking before this interview. Way too long, man. It's. I think the last time I saw you was could have been the MMVAs or something.
That's what I was thinking. It was award show, but I felt like I. Yeah, I think it was MMVAs. I felt like there was something else after that. But
Could have been.
It's been a couple years.
Yeah, but you know what? The funny thing is, even though I haven't seen you, I've seen your work. I don't know how many artists who I've interviewed who have you've produced or worked with or mentored or whatever else. Man, you're becoming a godfather in this system, man.
Just making music, man. You know, you know what it's been, man. We've known each other, well, probably 10 years now, probably, if not more. So it's been, just a kid who liked making music, you know, likes making beats. Obviously, the Rhea stuff did great. So just doing what we're doing, man, having fun with it, enjoying it.
But how do you make time, though? And I mean, you are working with a lot of artists. And, you know, I've been seeing them on Juno red carpets and big shows and stuff. Mm. Like, why is it important for you to help mentor these people, too? Because they are becoming the next big stars.
I don't even know if it's, like, I just like making music, you know, to be 100% honest. Mm-hmm. It's like, and when I see someone like Rio or David Miles, whoever it is, it's like, oh, I love what they're doing. I like them as a person, so I can sit there and hang out with them, get along with them. Let's make some music. And I think that's just kind of what I always did, whether it was producing my own stuff or producing for other people. I find that's just like another outlet besides doing the rap thing. It's like, I can do this other thing that still involves me doing music and stuff, but it's not the Classified brand. It's not like what I do for my own music. It's doing stuff that I typically probably wouldn't do for my own. So it's fun. It's just something, it's out of the box.
But the thing is, though, we are talking about new music. You got a new single out and an EP following with this, man.
Yeah. Just, you know, we've been hanging out in Enfield for the last year and a half. I haven't done any real shows in almost a year now. So been raising some kids, hanging out in the studio.
Excuse me, what? Back up?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I got three daughters.
Wow.
Yeah, man, I'm 9, 7, and 4. So, yeah, for the last year, I kind of just been chilling at home, hanging with the kids and my wife, and my studio's in my house. So, you know, bouncing between that. And excited, though. Excited to be back here doing this and put the new music out. So the first EP comes out tomorrow could be. And then we got another one coming in September, too. So
what's this EP about? Because I know some of the stuff that you've done, you know, you've talked about what's going on in life, what's going on in the streets. Hell, man, you even did, as we're talking, Canada Day coming up. You did a Canadian national anthem, too, man. What's this EP about, and how's it representing you today?
It just represents where I'm at. And, you know, like I said, every time we talk, it's like, oh, a new album. It's like, it's kind of just where I'm at in life now. And I think the biggest difference in this one from the other ones, though, is the fact that I kind of stepped away from it all for a minute and kind of reflected on it. And I think that comes out in a song called Changes that I put out. It's like, you know what I mean? It's me kind of looking at it going, like, I've been doing this for many years. I've been lucky enough to be successful with it. How long is this going to last? Like, is this still going where I want it to be going? You know what I mean? With kids, talking about that, having kids. Do I care about getting acceptance in the hip-hop world or whatever? Like, is it even that important to me anymore? Not really, you know what I mean? But I still enjoy making music. So it's kind of just talking about the balance of realizing that in life and balancing it with the kids.
Even though you're producing and working with other people and you got your own music happening too, 4 years, a lot changes. You know, stars that were, you know, playing in a bar are now playing at the ACC kind of thing. Did you look?
Man, we were just talking about the Arkells.
Exactly.
I saw that show they did on the weekend, which was crazy. And I remember playing with those guys in a bar in Newfoundland at the Junos, you know, 5 years, or when Canada came out, so 2010, you know. So the whole game's changed. The way people listen to music is completely different now. The much music isn't the make or break. You know what I mean? Like, it's a total different game now. So I'm a real person. I know I'm not this big superstar that's going to be every record I put out is number one and go. You know what I mean? Like, I get the game. So this is kind of me with Changes more so than anything, and this EP is just kind of reflecting of where I'm at now, looking at life and kind of going, what am I trying to do?
But you got the family, so are we going to get a chance to see shows happening? I mean, as we speak. You got one doing tonight.
Totally, and exactly, yeah. We got the show tonight, which is a real cool, like, it's a throwback to the hardcore fans who've been here for 10 years. We're doing, like, a bunch of old songs, bringing out, like, some fun, and Chocolate Air Meister are coming out. Like, guys that we've been doing music and messing with for, like, 10 years, and it's, you know, a kind of throwback to those fans who have been there that long, who still show that excitement, whether I have a number one song on the radio or if I'm just put my music out and some underground stuff, and they're still coming to check and show love. So it's, and but back to your question, yeah, I'm definitely, I got a big tour coming in October. We're going right across for 30 dates. So I'm still gonna get away from the family, hang with the boys a little bit, but you know, always got to come home to the kids and the wife and enjoy that too.
Look, I know you got more interviews you got to do today, but as we wrap this up, though, if we could go back to the guy who I remember, like I said, when I used to get up at 3 a.m. and I would see his videos then on Much Music. Yeah. It wasn't during the day. No, it was like 3 a.m. in the morning. Yeah, yeah, late night. What advice would you give that guy, classified back then, to the gentleman that I see today who, like I said, man, is working with so many people and really helping to establish the industry to another level?
What advice would I give myself? Just do what you're doing because it worked out.
That's the easiest thing you can say, man. Website, Twitter, it's like something we never really talked about before, man. You know, all that social media.
Right? The new world.
Where do we go to follow you?
Twitter, hit me up at Classified. I got in early, so I got that one, you know what I mean? Instagram, Classified Hip Hop. Facebook, Classified Music.
Always good seeing you, man. Congrats. Good to see you back.
My man. Thank you.